Hey, Kelly, that's right. It's a couple of things here. Bitcoin is suffering from that move away from higher growth, riskier assets. It's similar to what we've seen in tech stocks lately as the Fed moves to raise rates, and it is struggling to find new buyers. For today's action, that $40,000 mark you mentioned was a key psychological level, but automatic selling also played a role here. Noel Acheson of Genesis telling me that is where a lot of traders had what's known as stop losses. So once that level was breached, it triggered even more selling. Bitcoin did appear to find a support level there. At those lower levels, it's back above the $41,000 mark as we speak. Another factor, though, not a lot of new buyers or retail interest. As Glassnode puts it, the market saw a flush out in December from some of the traders who may have bought in at the top. And in the weeks and really months since, Bitcoin markets have seen, quote, little activity by newer market entrants. Longer-term holders, though, those who have had Bitcoin or held it for more than a couple months, have been accumulating more Bitcoin at these levels. So a little more action by the longer-term holders. And while spot markets have been pretty quiet, relatively, Bitcoin derivatives, especially short positions in Bitcoin, have been growing at what Glassnode calls an aggressive pace. So something to watch as well as for a potential risk there. And you got to mention Ether, too, here, the second largest cryptocurrency, down even bigger than Bitcoin today. Brian Kelly of BKCM telling me that it is becoming a higher beta way for institutions to play the crypto market. It's seen even deeper declines as some of these guys back away from risk.